Hello viewers, welcome to our channel again. Please keep watching our channel for more videos on literature. The poem that we are going to cover today is Church Going by Philip Larkin. Philip Arthur Larkin was his complete name. He was born in 1922 and died in 1985. English poet, novelist, essayist, and critic, a major poet of the post-World War II period, Larkin attempted to capture ordinary experience in realistic and traditional terms. Larkin's poetry both avoids romanticizing experience and moves away from the abstract experimental language of Iliad and modernists. Larkin's poetry has been characterized as combining an ordinary, colloquial style, clarity, a quiet, reflective tone, ironic understatement, and a direct engagement with commonplace experience. The motive to say is that his poetry was very much easily understandable by common people. Church Going is a medium-length lyrical poem that explores the issues of the church as a spiritual base. It begins ordinarily enough, as do many of Larkin's poems, then progresses deeper into the subject matter. The narrator questioning why people still need to go to church means, is there any need of religion in the modern era or not? Although set in England at a time when traditional religion was beginning to decline, the poet skillfully teases out more universal issues using metaphor and pun. Metaphor and pun are two poetic devices which we will study in my further videos. Larkin's narrator is initially just curious, stepping into a quiet church, but then becomes more perspective, knowledgeable and dry. Each stanza furthers the inquiry until the conclusion comes at the end, radical yet tempered. The speaker of the poem sneaks into a church after making sure it's empty. He lets the door thud shut behind him and glances around at all the fancy decorations, showing his ignorance of or indifference to how sacred all this stuff is supposed to be. After a short pause, he walks up to the altar. Altar is a table or flat-topped block used as the focus for a religious ritual, especially for making sacrifices or offerings. So he reaches to the altar and reads a few lines from the notes that are sitting on a lectern. Lectern is a tall stand with a sloping top to hold a book or notes from which someone, typically a preacher or lecturer, can read while standing up. After this, he walks back out of the church and slides an Irish sixpence. Irish sixpence is a small silver-colored coin used in the UK until 1971. So he slides an Irish sixpence into the collection box, which is basically like donating an old shirt button, like donating not by heart but just for the sake of name. The speaker thinks that the place was not worth stopping to check out, but he also admits that he did stop and that this is not the first time he has done so. He can't help but wonder what he is looking for when he keeps coming back to this place, and also asks himself about what will happen to churches when there are no more believers left in the world. He wonders if they will make museum out of the churches, or they will just leave the building's door open so that sheep can hang out inside them. So basically he is thinking about an aspect of future when the religion believer may extinct and churches will just be a building rather than a sacred place. nearing the end of the poem, the speaker asks, what will happen to the world when religion is gone altogether? Then he wonders what the very last religious person will be like. Will they be an obsessive compulsive who just can't stop wanting to smell incense? Or will they be more like the speaker, someone who is bored and ignorant about the church and just passing by without knowing what they are looking for? Finally, the speaker just comes out and admits that he is pleased by the church because it is a serious place for serious questions. Humanity, he concludes, will always have a hunger to ask those big questions like, why are we here and where do we go when we die? And for this reason, the kind of urge that created religion in the first place will never go away. Even if organized churches do. In the end, he says, sorry atheists, if you're looking for a poem that just trashes religion and calls spiritual people stupid, you will have to look someplace else. Throughout the poem, the speaker focuses very closely on his setting. The irony and wit of the poem, however, comes from the fact that the speaker doesn't focus on any of the things he is supposed to when he is inside the church. Instead, he wonders about practical concerns like whether or not the roof has been cleaned or restored. Overall, the speaker's reaction to the setting of this poem symbolizes the major theme of this poem, which is the gap between a person who is interested in religious faith and the deeper mystical meaning that only full-blown believers are familiar with. Setting up this relationship between the speaker and the setting shows us that the objects inside the church don't have any inherent meaning, but just the meaning that we give to them. But it also shows that the church does have a vague mystique that keeps the speaker coming back to check out the insides of churches. So we can summarize the poem by saying that the narrator comes to the conclusion churches will never go out of style, not only because of the integral role of religion in our society, but also because mankind has an innate need to believe in something greater than themselves. In case you are looking towards a face-to-face class, please contact us as per the given detail and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.